Since this is a photo fair, I wanted to start with my earliest work was photography. Since I've been 7 or 8, I've been crazy about cameras, and I had an Instamatic camera, and I ran around photographing my friends. I still have great images. I had a pretty good eye even that early, and candid shots on the playground, boys we had crushes on, all kinds of, just really tell, you know, they tell stories. And this work is from my early 20s, and I was interested in, these are friends of mine, it's a whole series, this is just one friend. I was interested in the transition these girls were going through from hard and tough and streetwise and punk rock and, you know, really living a kind of a non-nurturing lifestyle to preparing for motherhood and feeling very uncomfortable with that role. I found that binary fascinating. It paralleled to some degree my own parenting, which I realized later why I was so obsessed with making these portraits of pregnant women. At the time, nudity and pregnancy was pretty taboo. There's since been many media portrayals of this, so it's not that big of a deal anymore, but this was 1988. And I also have always had an interest in documenting subculture. So this is how I started. This, I'm jumping ahead to 2000 and 2007. And I had, in between that time, discovered performance video and performance art, and fell in love with those mediums. I'm primarily a performance video artist today. I still use photography. In this series, I framed real life events and framed them as performances. On the your left is me, and on the other side is me before and after being very, very ill with chronic fatigue syndrome and environmental illness. And I had a very long infirmary from these conditions. And the work is framing the politics behind the situation, because it's a CFS primarily affects women, and it wasn't taken seriously or federally validated for 24 years of me having the disease, just till 3 years ago, thanks to Obama, it was finally validated. I could finally go to a doctor and say, no, don't tell me this is psychosomatic, like I'm really sick. So all of that's framed in it, as well as the what I call the casualties of capitalism's commerce of toxic substances. Environmental illness for me started from getting poisoned by mercury and arsenic from a mining town I lived in. And this is still on the fringes of Western medicine's model of what's real, you know? So we have a systematic denial that what we do to our environment, we do to ourselves, which is a big issue for me. I would consider myself an ecologist and a feminist. There's also a binary between the transient and the corporeal existence, the surface versus the person. This work's been said to represent what society fetishizes as sexy, which is another theme in my work over the years. This is a shot of, on the right is the piece Muse, which is showing in the gallery. And I urge you all to go down and see the show, because I'm blown away by all the artists' work. I was really had an amazing night last night meeting all the women. It's all women. I wanted to show an install shot of it as opposed to a single channel version, because I imagine these as moving portraits that could be hung on a living room wall, and you have the media player plays on a loop. They're very minimal. This particular series is referenced after the fashion world, but I'm doing actions that you wouldn't necessarily see in a model shoot that are funny and subcultural and play with sexual stereotypes with a lot of wry humor. And the one muse that's playing is sexist text that's scrolling around my body kind of snake-like while I'm dancing, and it was all said by one kind of larger-than-life figure in the art world in Los Angeles over a three-year period that would often completely upset me and piss me off, and sometimes I found funny because I really love this guy, but he's, you know, of a certain generation in his late 70s, and that's how they talk about women. So it's just kind of a portrait of that reality. This is Bunny Girl. This is a film, a performance video movie that I made in 2016. I wanted to show stills because part of what I do as an artist is I frame. Going back to my eight-year-old self, I love to frame things. I love to be the cinematographer, but because I fell in love with performance art, I'm on both sides of the camera. So, and this piece is a lot about vulnerability, the vulnerability of women, the vulnerability of our environment, and how these two things interplay. The degradation of our environment is directly related to the suppression of the feminine principle, which is not gender-specific in my mind. These are principles that exist in all genders. We can all be nurturing. We can all be still. We have an overactive young world where we value the masculine principle over the feminine. And for me, this is why the world is rapidly warming, which is a young principle. So Bunny Girl follows a Playboy bunny in a dilapidated suit who goes through world disasters, Fukushima, mass species extinction. She's facing what's going on in the world, and she comes through nature and out the other side, a transformed woman. And this, I'm so excited to share with you because this is my new show that's up right now at SF Camera Works, which is at 111 Market Street at 6, and it's on the second floor. It's up through April 7th. It is a large scale, you can see. These are four installation shots. Performance video installation with 10 screens, four projections. Some are 14 foot high. We have a projection on water, which is the cooling feminine principle. And a circle ring of monitors that encase the audience in sacred space. There's two opposing characters. I'll show you, I don't know if you can see them. These are the two opposites. They're like the yin and the yang. And they loosely parallel my collaborator and I, who's a very masculine guy, John Sanborn. And we were at odds through the process a lot, and it really came out in the work, really stretched it and made it, I think, more dynamic. It's about the rise of the feminine principle. It's a requiem for our present moment that we're all dealing with, this politics and everything, we're global warming. And to give people a sense that we matter, that we all matter now. And it guides you through a ritual process of breathing and intention and wishes. And I just want to finish by saying that, you know, the mystical, the healing, natural medicine, I make flower essences on camera and then give them out at the show. These all can get you ostracized in the art world. These are subjects you're not supposed to put out there. And I really wanted to push that envelope. I felt like it was time. And just to kind of examine, like, why is that? I think there's racism implicit in it because we culturally look down on indigenous practices. I think it goes back to the burning times when they got rid of midwives and herbalists and their familiars. And this is all indicative of the torturing of the feminine yin principle, which is paralleling our burning landscape in California, and you see the parallel. We need more yin. And so yin, just to finish, is, let's see if I wrote it down, is nature, the non-linear, yin feminine, okay? The irrational, the nurturing, the internal. It's soft, it's still, it's moist, and it's cooling. We need this more than ever to balance the yang principle in our toxically masculine, destructive, rapidly warming world.